Good morning, students. Ready for the second class of English? Hope you have done your yesterday's homework and have practiced reading the story with correct pronunciation, stress, and intonation. But did you think over the central idea of the story? No? Yes? Good if yes. Before we take up today's class, let's discuss on the central idea of the story. Students, central idea means around which the story revolves. Now here, this story, a tale of two birds, revolve around and gives us the value that how this company affects us, or how the company affects the behavior and habits and attitudes of ours. Like in this story, the two birds, when got separated, they fell apart into different areas. One was near the gang of robbers and the other was near the Rishi's ashram. So one bird got a very bad company of robbers, where they were impolite, rude, and they always wanted to loot, right? On the other hand, the second bird got a very good company, the polite, nice, and a healthy atmosphere. So both developed their habits, their way of speaking, their attitudes, right? So the first bird behaved rude when the king sat near the tree it was on. On the other hand, when the king went off to the other tree and where the second bird near the Rishi ashram was there the king had a different experience, because same looking birds were different in their speech. The first one, as I earlier said, was behavior rude and impolite. But this bird, the second bird near the Rishi ashram, was very polite. So students, you must be hearing from your teachers, from your elders, your parents, that you should choose your friends very wisely, right? Why they're so concerned? Because they want you to follow good habits, to become wise, to be polite in behavior and develop healthy attitudes. So here I end with the discussion on the central idea. Hope you have understood. Now let's start with today's class. And the objectives of the day are, you'll be enhancing your vocabulary as I'll be telling you meanings and the usage of certain words. And you'll recall parts of speech and phrasal verb. The topics you have already covered in class 5 will be identifying in the story. So let's start with today's work. So the words I've chosen for the first page are shady. Look, shady tree. So here shady is an adjective, full of shade, right? Full of shade. Now adjective, the meaning is full of shade. If I have to use it in the two sentences, look here. The farmers usually rest under the shade of a tree during hot afternoons. Now here the shade refers to noun, abstract noun, right? But here if I have to rewrite the same sentence using shady, I have to write like this. The farmers usually rest under a shady tree during hot afternoons. Now here shady is an adjective. You can always change a noun to an adjective by adding y. This also you have learnt in class 5, right? Okay, moving on to the next word, storm. Storm is a violent disturbance of atmosphere with strong winds and rain. For example, the storm continued the most of the night. Ki tufan. Hindi mein isko storm ko kehte hain, tufan. Now here storm is a noun, right? And if you want to convert it to adjective, you just have to add y. It becomes an adjective. Now there are certain other words I've chosen for you. They are fortunately, robbers, amazed, faint, clearing, alike, imitates. Now all these words are there used in the book, right? So let's discuss one by one. The way I have written with proper meaning and sentences, I want you to complete this exercise after watching this video, right? At the end of the lesson, as a homework. Okay, let's start fortunately. Fortunately means having good fortune. Bhagyavash. Luckily, you could say luckily. Robbers. Robbers means thieves. Now, this is a phrasal verb. I will be discussing it little later. Let's focus on the vocabulary of page 2. Again, the phrasal verb followed by got off. Now, the vocabulary word chosen for you is amazed. Amazed means surprised. Next word, faint. Faint means something very weak, feeble. And that's not clear. Here it says, faint noises issuing from the cave. That means the very weak noises, which were not very much clear, but were coming from the cave. Okay? Come to the next word, clearing. Clearing here refers to forest. Like, soon he came to a clearing, which looked like an ashram. It's a place in the forest, right? Okay. Come back to the next, I'll be coming. Here, this is an idiom, right? Made friends with. Now, this is an idiom. When you always say made friend with, that means you begin friendship with someone. I have made friends with Gia. That means now I have Gia and I are friends. Now, come to the next word, alike. Alike means similar. I and my brother are alike in our habits. That means we have similar habits, right? Now, the last word to know is imitates. Imitates means copies. Now, you must have seen monkeys imitating. No? They copy whatever you do. So, let's revise the vocabulary. Shady, storm, fortunately, robbers, amazed, faint, issuing, clearing, alike, imitates. I want you all to finish writing with proper the part of speech and the meanings. And I would love if you really make sentences as well. That would be your homework for the day. Now let's come to the phrasal verbs I mentioned earlier. Now, what is a phrasal verb? Phrasal verb is also an idiomatic phrase. And it consists usually of a verb, or in addition to it, you would either find adverb or preposition or both. Like, for example, look at these phrasal verbs. Get, get up, get back, get in. See, but they have a different meaning. Get up means rise up. When your mother must say, get up, that means you rise up from bed. Get back is to return to something. Get back to your work. That means you have to return to your work where you started, no? Get in is to enter. So, just using this word different with get in combination to get, the meaning changes. So, such are called phrasal verbs. Now, what is a phrase? Let me remind you that phrase is a group of words making some partial sense, not a complete sense. Sentence makes a complete sense, whereas phrase, the partial sense. Now, these are the phrasal verbs used in the book. Blew down. Did you remember the sentence? The wind blew down many trees. That means the trees were fallen by the force of wind. See, it is used when wind makes something fall, blew down. When I say came down is again to fall. In book, it is one of them came down near a cave. That means he fell near a cave, right? Then followed by, on the next page, we have king followed by the king. Here it means king is after something. Followed by is when you use this followed by, that means you want to say what comes after that, right? Okay, got off. Here the king got off his horse. That means he left the horse and just separation, the sense of separation, right? Now the last phrasal verb, look up. He looked up and saw a big brown bird. Now, actually, look up means to try finding out some information. Here, he also looked up and wanted to find some information where the voice was coming from. So, these are the phrasal verbs. So, today, I have taught you 3 concepts. The word meanings, their usage, and identifying phrasal verbs. So, today's homework would be, you will note down the vocabulary of the lesson, all the circled words, right? The words I have circled in this format, okay? And you will note them down, the phrasal verbs. Hope you have understood. For any queries, you can leave your messages. I will clarify your doubt. Thank you.